What if you were swallowed by a hippo? The hippo is the third largest land mammal on Earth, after the elephant and the rhinoceros. Their closest relatives are whales, from which they diverged about 55 million years ago. Hippos are semi-aquatic animals, inhabiting rivers, lakes, and mangrove swamps. They spend the day submerged in river mud and come out at dusk to graze on the grass. For the most part, they are herbivores and can weigh up to 1,500 kilograms. It takes a lot of energy to carry all that mass around, so these hungry hippos have to eat 35 kilograms of food every night. In this video, we're going to take a look at what would happen if you became their latest meal and were swallowed by a hippo. Before we look at this, a quick reminder to give this video a thumbs up if you're enjoying it, and also to subscribe to Brain Impact for more videos just like this one. But now, back to the hippo. Hippos are large, loud, and dangerous. They kill 500 people a year in Africa, and their attacks are vicious. A sure sign that a hippo is about to attack is when they look as if they are yawning, but there would be little point in running as they can charge at up to 19 miles per hour. If you're not on foot and instead you decide to take a boat, you have even less chance, as they often glide underneath a small boat, flipping it and throwing its passengers into the water. While hippos are pretty big animals, they wouldn't be able to swallow you whole. It would take a lot of biting and chewing on their part, and would be unbelievably painful on yours. They have three stomach chambers, and they use a method of digestion called foregut fermentation. Firstly, parts of your body would travel down the hippo's throat into the first chamber of its stomach, where microbacteria would begin to break down that body part. Next, it would travel on to the true stomach of the hippo, where digestive enzymes would continue to break it down. Later, the animal would open its bowels with remnants of your body part and some grass being flung over its territory. Male hippos can become aggressive if they sense danger. Mothers may attack to protect their young, and nearly all hippos become nervous when something, or someone, stands between them and the water where they live. They will attack instantly and without warning if they feel either of those are under threat. The hippo is among the most dangerous animals in the world due to its highly aggressive and unpredictable nature. It's able to open its mouth at almost 180 degrees and clamp down with a force 10 times that of a human jaw. Hippo teeth sharpen themselves as they grind together. The lower canines and incisors grow continuously, with the incisors reaching up to 40 centimeters and the canines up to 50 centimeters. Being a herbivore, their diet in nature consists almost entirely of grass, but if faced with what they feel is a threat, they would not hesitate to sink their huge teeth into a human. Although they could not swallow a whole human, it would not take much for them to rip you apart and eat parts of your body a bit at a time. There have been a couple incidents reported concerning hippo attacks on humans. The first is probably the most well-known, in Zimbabwe. The story of Paul Templer, the man swallowed by a hippo whilst leading a group of tourists in kayaks. Templer had been working this particular stretch of river for many years, and the hippo had carried out the occasional half-hearted attacks in the past. But this time was different. Whilst paddling past a group of hippos, one of Templer's colleagues got flipped out of his kayak by the bull. Noticing what was happening, Templer attempted to go to the aid of his colleague, but within minutes he found himself, from the waist up, in the mouth of the hippo. As he struggled to get away, the hippo flung him around like a dog with a rag doll, then spat him out. Templer and his friend began to swim for their lives, but unfortunately they were no match for the hippo. The second time around, the animal swallowed Templer feet first, sinking his head underwater. Again, the hippo spat him out, only to come back and try once more. On the third attack, the animal grabbed him by the torso, sinking his teeth into his lungs. Amazingly, Templer was eventually able to escape, and came away with an exposed lung, 38 bite wounds, and consequently had to have one of his arms amputated. Sadly, his colleague lost his life. Then there's the curious case of Marius Els, a South African farmer who was savagely killed by his pet hippo in 2011. Els had raised the hippo himself since the time it was 5 years old. He called it Humphrey. He would ride the hippo through the river as if he was on a mechanical bull, feed him apples, and swim with him. One Saturday evening, Els was found on his farm. He had been bitten several times by Humphrey and held underwater for an unknown period of time. He was declared dead at the scene. Els had been previously quoted as saying, "I trust Humphrey with my heart that he will not harm anybody." We think that the moral of the story is, if you decide to invade the territory of a hippo, be prepared for the consequences. You can be sure it will always be the animal that has the upper hand. And if you think a hippo would make a perfect pet, think again. What do you think of the hippo? Would you be brave enough to go kayaking in Africa? Let us know in the comments box, and please like this video if you've enjoyed it. If you want to see more videos like this one, then subscribe to Brain Impact for more. Thanks for watching.